Well, before we jump into our interview with Travis, really quick, for those of you who may be unfamiliar with AccuLynx, we are the leading all-in-one business management software designed to help roofing contractors manage and grow their business. So a little bit about us. We were founded in 2008, and our goal has always been to accommodate the needs of the retail and insurance restoration contractor. Over the years, we've won numerous awards, 10 just this year. And today we serve thousands of roofing contractors across the US and Canada. So we'll give you a little bit more info on the system later, but I don't want to hold up what you're here for, and that's to hear from Travis. So everyone, please meet Travis Crego. He is Estimator of Options Exteriors and our guest star today. Travis, thank you so much for being here with us today.
Thank you, Michelle.
Why don't you start by telling us a little bit about yourself and about your company?
I mean, a little bit about me, it just had me thinking about like how I wound up here. Like I've been working in the office for like just about 3 years. I started as a sales rep for Options Exteriors back in like around May 2020. And then I got into being an admin assistant in March of 2021. But I mean, just before that, I had a career in banking, customer service background. And that was just not working out for me. I kind of had a quarter life crisis and I knew I wanted to make a change. And I met a friend who was selling. He got me into it. I got myself into it. But after selling, I kind of discovered I didn't have as much hunger for selling as I did for really trying to get into this company and seeing how I can really get to streamlining things. Options Exteriors, I know that got kind of going right around 2020 or early 2020, Options Exteriors really began. So I've kind of been with it as the name started.
Awesome. Can you tell us a little bit about the markets that you serve and the type of roofing that you do?
Yeah, so I mean, we're primarily in Minnesota. We do a lot as well in Iowa, Wisconsin. We will work in North Dakota, South Dakota, and we do residential and commercial.
Awesome. Well, as you mentioned, you joined Options Exteriors a few years ago, and the focus that we want to have for this live interview is really telling us how you've taken the data that was running through your system at the time, how you've managed that and changed it and really been able to improve the way that you manage your reporting processes and the impact that that's had overall for your company. So just to kind of get us started, when you joined, how was Options Exteriors managing all of the roofing data across all of your different departments?
Yeah, how it was being managed in the beginning is AccuLynx was primarily used for accounting. Accounting was set up seemingly very well, which is good. Then from there, we had AccuLynx primarily just for job files, for just getting the documents up into, like getting it in there for storage into the files themselves for jobs, and as well as just using it for communications to the reps, suppliers, just, you know, sending communications out back and forth. And that was really kind of the extent of that, because we used a second web application, Google Spreadsheets, to pretty much put everything else into, especially for production, tent for, you know, repairs management, different types of production, different trades. Like it was all jammed into a spreadsheet to where what was ready, when you could do it. We had to take information in the file and put it over into the spreadsheet. So that was just a lot of extra double data entry. That was kind of really it. I just remember there was just such a massive use of our Google spreadsheets for pushing jobs along.
Yeah, I'm sure a lot of other companies are familiar with managing things through spreadsheets and how difficult that can be when there's a lot of different people with access to it as well.
I imagine like the way that other contractors are doing it is they're not fully in AccuLynx, say, or using Google Spreadsheets did work, or they're using like a wall to manage their production process.
Right. So when you came in, that process was obviously, there were some problems with it, I assume. There were a lot of these processes that were in place with these spreadsheets that were causing bottlenecks in operations.
Yes, and some of those to go into. I mean, the spreadsheets did work pretty well. I mean, there was a lot of trust because when someone had to put something in the spreadsheet, you hope they did it.
Right.
I think what was lacking was you always knew, you know, for things that were going the way they're supposed to and what there was to do. And just that alone, like, you know, we're already working full time, if not overtime, just doing, you know, working on things that went the way they're supposed to, pushing it forward. But then once you like would push it out and it went into sort of a pending progress mode, there just wasn't visibility. Let me try to get an example of that. That could be for maybe roofing is done, like, you know, consistently getting gutters going. Oh, there's a repair. Man, I could dive into some of those. Just let me know because.
Yeah, give us some example of like a process that was, you know, really bottlenecked because you had to manage things in a spreadsheet versus in a CRM.
I mean, repairs would just wind up on a spreadsheet, but then it wouldn't always be updated by someone, and it kind of became where things would move through, but it was a lot on the sales rep to kind of bark at us saying, hey, what's the next step here? Because I think what was going on was we needed to maybe order something for the repair and we sent it out, but there wasn't like something gathering all that data for those items for, oh, it's been several weeks, maybe we should check on what's going with that. We're just kind of hoping that we get the email back to then trigger us to then push it forward again. Right. So there just wasn't any of that for, I know, repairs.
Was this sort of thing impacting other departments as well? Like I know you talked about there were some issues with production then because of this.
Yeah, just I think what the big thing was is that it really kind of didn't allow you to really focus on a lot of like things that were like similar because you always were jumping out of order, having random things that, you know, you were not on top of that. Now you're getting blasted by maybe your boss or something saying, hey, like, why hasn't this moved? And there's just a lot of time being extended with the job cycle. So
were there issues like were you coming up with like how many hours would you say that this was setting you guys back in terms of just identifying these issues and then having to go through and resolve them?
I think just several hours a day because we didn't have anything to see where all these collected. So on top of us just doing what we're responsible for, like all we had to do from there was we had to scrub through every job file just to see, you know, that would be like what we'd be asked to do. I mean, our boss back, you know, when there were still a lot of jobs back a year ago would spend a weekend just clicking on every job.